Hi students, I am G. Sangeeta, PGT in Physics, working in Dr. Vijayan Metric Higher Secondary School, Arakkonam. And now in Physics, Unit 1, Electrostatics, we are going to see the topic, Electric Field Due to Continuous Charge Distribution. So we know that the electric charges are quantized microscopically. And already in the previous topics, we have seen about Coulomb's Law, then superposition principle and electric fields. And in those topics, we have dealt with the point charges and we have used the expression for that. In case if it is a charge wire or charge sphere, we couldn't use that point charge expression for that. It is very difficult. So we have to consider the charge is uniformly distributed on the given surface. If it is uniformly distributed, we have to use the continuous charge distribution. For that, we will be using the method of calculus. So if the charge is distributed continuously, then we will be using the method of calculus. So for that, we are considering an irregular shape charge object. You can see that irregular shape charge object here, and we can consider n number of charges. And the charge elements are denoted by del Q1, del Q2, del Q3, etc. up to del Qn for the n number of charges. And now you can see that from the point P to the charge element, it is separated by a distance of corresponding R1, R2 and R3. So that we can write the electric field. So the definition here, before the statement here, is the electric field at the point P due to the charge object is equal to the sum, vector sum of the electric field due to the all the other charge elements. By using that, we are going to write the expression E vector, which is approximately equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught del Q1 divided by R1P square R1P cap. And here this expression is according to the electric field, what we have seen before. And here this del Q1 represents the first charge element. Like that, it is second charge element, it is corresponding n charge elements. So del Q represents the point charges. And here this R1P, it represents the distance of the point P from the charge element. And R1P cap represents the unit vector from the first charge element to the point P. The same way here, instead of writing this plus sign here, we can use the summation. So E vector, which is approximately equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, instead of using this plus, in short we are writing that summation I equal to 1 to n del qi divided by rip square rip cap. So here this I, it tends from the value of 1 to n. Just now I told you this ip, this r represents the distance of the point P from the ith charge element, and this rip cap represents the unit vector from the ith charge element to the point P. And now here in this expression we have seen that it is only approximate value. So instead of using the approximation, we can use the integral method. So here the limit del Q, if it tends to 0, then we can take this value is equal to dQ. So now the electric field, in terms of integration, we can write this as electric field E vector is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught integral dQ divided by R square into R cap. So this dQ represents the infinitesimal charge. Infinitesimal charge is denoted by dQ, and R represents the distance of at the point P from the charge element. And now this R cap represents the unit vector from the charge to the point P. And now we already know that force F vector is equal to Q into E vector. F is the force, Q is the charge, and E is the electric field. And now we are going to find out the electric field for the various objects and various dimensions. So here we are taking wire, and it is of infinite length, and in that infinite length we are taking only a small length, which is known as infinitesimal length, and that is denoted by dl. So here the charge is uniformly distributed on the length of the wire and the linear charge density is denoted by lambda. So lambda is equal to Q divided by L. The unit for this linear charge density is coulomb meter inverse. Why it is coulomb means we know that the unit for charge is coulomb, the unit for length is meter. So the unit for this linear charge density is coulomb meter inverse. Now next we are going to find out the charge present in the infinitesimal length dl. So the charge is denoted by dq and the linear charge density lambda into the infinitesimal length dl. So dq is equal to lambda into dl. So with this expression we can find out the electric field due to the line of total charge q. So this is the answer for electric field. E vector is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught integral dq divided by r square into r cap. We know that from the previous expression dq is equal to lambda into dl divided by r square into r cap. Just we are substituting the value of dq here in this equation, the remaining things as it is. So we are taking this lambda outside the integral. So lambda divided by 4 pi epsilon naught integral dl divided by r square into r cap. In this method we can find out the electric field for a wire. The next thing, to find out the electric field of the surface of area A. So now here in the surface area we are going to distribute the charge uniformly on the surface of area A. So the surface charge density is denoted by sigma and here linear charge density lambda, and here surface charge density is denoted by sigma, which is equal to Q divided by A. Q is the charge, A is the area, and the unit for this is, we know that the unit for charge is coulomb and the unit for area is meter inverse square. And here you can see the wire diagram as well as for the surface area. So in this surface area we are going to find out what is this dq, that is the charge present in the infinitesimal area dA. So that the charge is denoted by dq, which is equal to sigma into dA. Just we are rearranging it with the small change here, that is infinitesimal area, so it is denoted by dA, and here the charge, it is denoted by dq. The next thing, we are going to find out the electric field due to the surface area of total charge q. So electric field E vector is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. We know the formula already, what we have seen here, the same formula, integral dq divided by r square into r cap. Now we are going to substitute the value of dq here in this equation, so which is nothing but sigma into dA. And if you are substituting it here, 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught integral sigma dA divided by r square into r cap. Just we are taking that sigma outside the integral. So 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught sigma integral dA divided by r square into r cap. And these are the corresponding diagram for this wire as well as for the surface area. The next case in this electric field due to continuous charge distribution is with volume. So if the charge is distributed uniformly in the volume, then the volume charge density is denoted by rho is equal to q divided by v. So rho is the volume charge density and q is the charge and v is the volume. Now the charge present in the infinitesimal volume element is denoted by dv. So infinitesimal volume element is dv, so dq is equal to rho into dv. Already we know the expression for the electric field. So electric field due to a volume of total charge q, E vector is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught integral dq divided by r square into r cap. Instead of this dq, we are going to substitute this value here, which is rho dv. So E vector is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught integral rho dv divided by r square into r cap. And now just we are taking this rho outside the integral. So the expression is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught rho integral dv divided by r square into r cap. And this diagram represents the volume V and the point P, which is at a distance of r. And now the next topic is about electric field lines. So electric field vectors are visualized by the concept of electric field lines. So they are set of continuous lines which are the visual representation of electric field at some region of space. And that is about electric field lines. So that is nothing but the visual representation of electric field vectors. While drawing this electric field lines for the charges, we have to follow this rules. So the rules followed while drawing the electric field lines for charges is, the first point, the electric field lines, it starts from the positive charge and it ends at the negative charge or at infinity. You can see here, this represents the positive charge and this is the negative charge. So the electric field, it starts from the positive. You can see the arrow mark here. So it starts from the positive and it ends at the negative charge, or it may end at infinity also if it is at the longer distance. If it is a positive charge only, there is a presence of positive point charge, what about the electric field? If it is a positive point charge, you can see the electric field arrow mark, you can see that it is pointing radially outward for the positive charge. So positive point charge is radially outward. Then for the negative point charge, what about the electric field lines? For the negative charge, the electric field lines, they are pointing inwards, radially inwards towards the negative charge. And this is for the negative charge. And already we have seen this positive charge. You can find the difference between these two things. Positive means radially outward. Negative means radially inward. So in case, if it is an isolated point charge, if it is an isolated charge, where it is starting? It is starting from the positive and it may end at infinity. And that is for the positive point charge. In case, if it is for a negative point charge, you can see the electric field lines. If it is an isolated point charge also, it starts from infinity and it ends at the negative charge. So positive means it starts from positive and ends at infinity. For negative means it starts from infinity and ends in the negative charge. And that is about the first point in this rules which we have to follow. The next thing, the electric field line, you can see here the electric field line E vector, electric field vector at a point P, it is tangential to this electric field lines at that point. And that is the second point. Electric field vector E is tangential to the electric field lines at that point. And that is shown in this diagram here. The next thing, the third point, you can see the area here. The third point, what we have to follow in this rules. You can see the electric field lines over here. And we can see area A and area B over here. And in this area A, which is close to this charge, you can see the number of lines, they are denser in the region A, that is closer together in the region A compared to that in the region B. So here the lines are denser in the region A, that is surface A, compared to the surface B, and here it is less dense. So the number of lines which is crossing through this given area is directly proportional to the magnitude of the electric field. How many lines it is crossing through that area, that gives you the magnitude of electric field. From this we know that, already we know that electric field, it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. So if the distance increases, the electric field decreases. So from this diagram, you can understand that there is surface A, it is closer here. And here the surface B, it is at somewhat distance. So here the electric field at the surface A is greater compared to the electric field at the surface B. And that is about the third rule what we have to follow here. The next thing, no two electric fields intersect with each other. They never intersect with each other. They start from positive and terminate at negative or at infinity. They never intersect with each other. If the two lines, if they cross at any point over here, then there will be two different electric fields. If you are placing a charge over here, in case if you are placing a charge at a point here, then it will be moving in two different directions, which is actually not possible. So no two field lines intersect with each other. So here, if you are placing a charge at this point, then there will be two different electric fields. You can see that here it is denoted by E1 and E2. And that is the next rule what we have to follow. Then the last here, the last rule is the number of electric field lines that emanating from the positive or ends at negative, is directly proportional to the magnitude of the charge. So it means the number of lines which is coming out from the charge, it is nothing but the magnitude of the charge. And here you can see one diagram with the positive sign. We can take this as plus Q. If it is plus Q, how many number of lines over here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So that is the number of field lines for the charge plus Q. The same way here I am denoting the negative sign, which is of 2Q here, and you can count the number of lines. That number of field lines is equal to 9 here. And that is about the rules what we have to follow while drawing the electric field lines for charges. The next topic is electric dipole. We'll first see the definition for this electric dipole. Two equal and opposite charges, if they are separated by a very small distance, that will constitute the electric dipole. And here you can see minus Q and plus Q are the two charges, two equal and opposite charges, and they are separated by a distance here, and that this charges separated by a distance will constitute the electric dipole. The charges, they never coincide with each other. In many molecules, they never coincide. So they have the permanent electric dipole. The example for that is carbon monoxide, water, ammonia, hydrochloric acid, etc. And these are the example for the electric dipole. So the next topic is about electric dipole moment. So electric dipole moment is denoted by P vector, which is equal to Q R plus vector minus Q R minus vector. So this Q plus Q and minus Q represents the charges, and R plus represents the position vector of the charge from the origin, charge plus Q from the origin, and R minus represents the position vector of charge minus Q from the origin. Then to find out the electric dipole, we can write the formula. P vector is equal to Q, which is charge, and A represents the distance from the origin to one charge. It is denoted by A. If it is along the x-axis, we'll take that axis as I cap, minus Q, which is the other charge, and A is the distance from the origin. If you can take this as an origin, from origin to this distance is denoted by A, and origin to this distance is denoted by A. So here this A into minus I cap, which is, in case if it is in the direction opposite, we'll be using the vector minus I cap. So on minus and minus it becomes plus, so that 2Q A I cap. And this electric dipole moment, it will be acting along the vector joining the two charges from minus Q to plus Q. The SI unit for this electric dipole moment is given by Coulomb meter. Why? Because the unit for charge is Coulomb and the unit for distance is meter. And next we are going to see two important points regarding this electric dipole. In case if there are two charges, if it is placed along the x-axis, then also the unit vector will be acting from the charge minus Q to plus q. In case if it is placed along the y axis or z axis, then also the electric dipole moment will be pointing from the charge minus q to plus q. And here we can define this electric dipole moment. So here you can see the modulus of P vector. It represents the magnitude of the electric dipole moment is equal to the product of magnitude. You can split this as Q into 2A. So with this you can define, the product of magnitude of one of the charge into the distance. That will give you the magnitude of electric dipole moment, and that is the definition for electric dipole moment. So electric dipole moment is defined as the product of magnitude of one of the charge and the distance between them. The next thing is, in case if it is one charge, or in case if there is a two positive charge, or in case if there are two negative charges, like that, in case if there are n number of charges present, then also you can find out the electric dipole moment for the n point charges by using the formula P vector is equal to summation I equal to 1 to n Qi Ri vector. So this Ri vector represents the position vector of the charge from the origin. That is about electric dipole. Based upon this electric dipole, we are going to see the next topic, that is electric field due to an electric dipole at points on the axial line. You can see one diagram here. In this diagram, you can identify which is the electric dipole. And this is acting along the x-axis. Along the axial line means we can consider along x-axis. And here A and B are the two points which we are considering along the x-axis. And we are placing the charge minus q and plus q. So minus q is present at the point A and plus q at the point B. And that constitutes the electric dipole. Two equal and opposite charges separated by a distance here. And here the distance here, it is denoted by, from this origin to this distance is A, and from this origin to this distance is also denoted by A here. So now O represents the origin, minus Q and plus Q represents the electric dipole which is acting along the axial line. And along this axial line we are considering another point C which is at a distance of R from the origin of this electric dipole. And next, here this E plus and E minus, and these are all the electric fields what we are going to find out with this expressions. Now first, electric field at the point C, at this point C, we are going to find out the electric field due to the charge plus Q. Due to this charge plus Q, we are going to find out the electric field at this point C. So the electric field is denoted by E plus vector. Why? Because it is for the charge plus Q. So it is E plus vector is equal to 1 divided by, we know the general expression for electric field, 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R square. Based upon that expression, 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q here represents this plus Q divided by R minus A the whole square. How we are getting this R minus A means from this origin to this point C is R, and we know that from the origin to plus Q is A. So here we are finding out the distance from plus Q to C. So it is R minus A the whole square which is acting along this BC. And this electric dipole moment, it is denoted by P vector. It is directed along BC and it will be acting from the charge minus Q to plus Q. And now instead of writing this along BC, just we are going to replace it with the unit vector, and we know that unit vector is directed from the charge minus Q to plus Q. So here E plus vector is equal to the same equation, 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q divided by R minus A whole square. Instead of along BC, just we are writing the unit vector along with this, and this represents the electric dipole moment unit vector, and it is directed from minus Q to plus Q. Now next we are going to find out for E minus vector. So that is electric field at a point C due to the charge minus Q. For the minus Q we are finding out. So E minus vector is equal to minus. Why we are using minus here means because it is the charge minus Q. So that minus here 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught q divided by r plus a whole square. Why it is r plus a means we know that from O to C it is r, from O to A it is a, and here the electric field is found out between the two points A and C. So it is r plus a the whole square, along with that the unit vector, electric dipole moment unit vector p cap. So that is about E plus vector and E minus vector. And with this diagram, you know that E plus vector is here and E minus vector is here. So which will be stronger? So E plus vector is stronger compared to that of the E minus vector. Why? Because E plus vector, it is near to this point C here, and the negative charge, it is far away compared to that of the positive charge. So E plus, it is stronger compared to that of E minus. So that we are drawing the line here, you can see this line E plus vector, this line is greater compared to that of this E minus. You can see only this much distance, and for E plus this is the distance, and that is E plus is stronger, so that we are drawing a longer line for the E plus, and E minus is lesser, so smaller line. Then we are going to find out the electric field at the point C. To find out the electric field at this point C, we are going to apply the superposition principle for this electric field. By applying the superposition principle, E total vector is equal to E plus vector, what we have found out here, and along with this E minus vector, what we have found out here, just we are going to add these two values. Why we are using minus sign here means because of this minus here, we are using the minus sign here, just substituting the values. 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r minus a whole square p cap minus 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r plus a whole square into p cap. Just substituted these two values here in this. And now, just to find out the E total value, q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, just we are taking that q value outside the bracket. The remaining value is 1 by r minus a whole square minus 1 by r plus a whole square into the unit vector. Next, we are going to simplify this values which is inside the bracket. In the denominator, you can see r minus a whole square and r plus a whole square. And you have to simplify that by using the formula here, a minus b whole square into a plus b whole square. So that which is equal to a square minus b square the whole square. So according to that formula, r minus a whole square into r plus a whole square is equal to r square minus a square whole square. Then taking LCM for this numerator, it is r plus a whole square minus r minus a whole square. We know already a plus b whole square formula and a minus b whole square formula. By using that formula here, just we are writing the values here. We are using a plus b whole square formula for this r plus a whole square. So it is r square plus a square plus 2ra. This minus sign here, just I'm taking that minus sign inside this expression. So we know that a minus b whole square formula, applying that formula here for this r minus a whole square. So r square, we are taking this minus value inside, so minus a square plus 2ra. I hope you have understood that, because you know the formula of a minus b whole square and a plus b whole square. Then simplifying this, r square and r square will get cancelled, a square and a square will get cancel now. So the remaining term is 2ra and 2ra. While adding that, you will be getting 4ra. The remaining things as it is. E total vector is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught 4ra divided by r square minus a square whole square into p cap. And now, just to simplify this denominator, we are using the comparing the distance, and we are comparing the distance of r and a. So you can see here the r distance is greater compared to that of the a. So that r is greater than a means just we are neglecting that a value only in the denominator. Why? Because it is with the negative sign here, it doesn't make much difference. So we are neglecting this a value. Instead of writing r minus a the whole square, we are writing it as r square. So r square whole square is nothing but r power 4. The numerator as it is. So E total vector is equal to q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught 4ra divided by r power 4. So this r and this r power 4 will get cancelled. So that your equation is q by 4 pi epsilon naught 4a divided by r cube into p cap. Just we are simplifying that. For the simplification, we are splitting this 4a as 2 into 2. So that 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 into 2 QA divided by R cube into P cap. Just we are taking this 2 QA into P cap as the P vector, which is nothing but the unit vector is taken as electric dipole moment vector, P vector. So P vector is equal to 2 QA P cap. So if you are substituting it here, the 2 as it is, remaining this terms can be taken as P vector. So E total vector is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 as it is and P vector divided by R cube. For this we have to draw one diagram here, minus Q plus Q origin, and they are separated by a distance and the point C, and you can see the total vector which is acting along the x axis, which is acting along the direction from minus Q to plus Q. In case if you are shifting this point C towards the left side, if you are choosing the point C on the left hand side, then the direction of the electric field will be along the direction of the P vector. And this question is a very, very important question. Thank you.